Hello everyone, welcome to Excel 10 tutorial. In this quick Excel tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can highlight cell based on today's date in Microsoft Excel. Let's get started. Take a look at this cell here, P9. Here we have today's date. And now I want to create a system where if this cell has today's date, it should be highlighted in yellow. If it doesn't have today's date, I don't want any highlighting, okay? So we have today's date here. Let's change the date to yesterday's date. Okay. Now I'm going to do it using conditional formatting. So select the cell that you want to highlight based on your condition, or in this case, today's date. So I have selected the cell where I have date, and this is the cell I want to highlight. And now I'm going to click on conditional formatting and click on new rule. Then I'm going to click here, use a formula to determine which cells to format. And now I'm going to write here equal to, and then I'm going to click on the cell that has date, which is P9. And take a look at here, we have dollar sign before P and before 9. That means this is an absolute cell reference. That means our conditional formatting will work only on this cell and it will not work on any other cell. Okay, I'm going to explain different option a bit later. So we have selected our cell, and then I'm going to add another equals, and then I'm going to write the today function, which is TODAY and open and close parentheses. Okay, so today function doesn't have any parameters, that's why I haven't given any parameters here. So if our specific cell, which is P9 equal to today's date, then we want to format. So I'm going to click here format and click here the fill color and select yellow and click OK and click OK again. Now you can see our cell color or the fill color hasn't changed because this is not today's date. If I add today's date here and press enter, you can see this cell has been highlighted. Again, if I change the date, highlighting is gone. If I change it back to today's date, our cell is automatically highlighted. Okay, now let's remove this conditional formatting from here, from home, conditional formatting, clear rules, and then clear rules from selected cell. Okay, so our conditional formatting is removed. Now again, we can do the same thing using conditional formatting, but a bit easier way. Okay, for that you'll have to click on home and then click on conditional formatting. Now highlight cell rules, and then you can see we have an option, a date occurring. If I click here, now if I click on this drop down, you can see we have yesterday, today, tomorrow, and a lot of dates here. That means we can highlight all the cell that has last week dates. We don't need those, we need today. So we are going to click on today. And now here in this drop down, we can select the highlighting option. I'm going to click on this drop down and select custom format. Okay, now I'm going to select the yellow and click OK. Now you can see our cell is highlighted, but if I change this date to any other date except today's date, the highlighting is gone. If I add today's date here again, and I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut, which is Control semicolon, and press enter, and you can see this is our today's date and this is highlighted. So this is how you can highlight cell based on today's date. But this is a single cell. I'm going to show you another option, a bit practical one. So I'm going to click all this and take a look at this table here. We have different data here and we have date in column M. Now, if you want to highlight all the cell that has today's date in this column, and to be specific, from cell M1 to M701. So we have selected this range, and now if you want to highlight all the cell between this selected range, not the entire row or not the entire column, just between selected range, and you want to highlight based on today's date like we have done just now. This is a bit practical example and we use this all the time. We are going to do this in the same way, just selected the entire range instead of that single cell. Okay, so our range is selected, which is cell M1 to M701. Okay, now I'm going to click on conditional formatting, click on highlight cell rules, and here a date occurring, and we can click on this drop down and select today, and click on this drop down, custom format, and then select this color and click OK. If I click OK again, and you can see all the cell that has only today's date are now highlighted, like this one, this one, this one, this one. But all the other cells that doesn't have today's date is not highlighted. This one has today's date. Okay. Now, what if you want to remove this conditional formatting? There are two ways. One, you can remove every conditional formatting from this worksheet. If you don't want that, then select the data range where you have your conditional formatting. I'm going to select the entire column here and then click on conditional formatting and clear rules. And you can see clear rules from selected cells. So I'm going to click this one, and all the conditional formatting is now removed. And if you want to use formula in your conditional formatting, for that I'm going to select the range again where we have data, which is cell M1 to M701. And now if I click on conditional formatting and then new rule, use a formula to determine which cell to format. And here we have an excellent scenario. If I click here, the first cell, which is M1, okay? And now if I write here equal to today, open and close parentheses, and click on the format and click on this yellow, and it will not work. Why? Because we have selected entire range or entire column, or we have selected part of a column. But here in our cell reference, we have used the absolute cell reference, okay? This will never work because it will only check the first cell, which is cell M1. And if that is today's date, it will highlight. Otherwise, it will not work. But if I remove this dollar sign before the one, which makes the column name absolute reference, but the row number is relative, okay? So it will not work in column L or column N or any other column, because column M is absolute reference, okay? But our row number is relative reference. That's why it will check every cell or every row within our selected range and check if that cell contains today's date, and then it will format in yellow. If I click OK, and you can see it has done that. First cell is today's date. It has highlighted. Now let's change this date to today's date. I'm going to use control plus semicolon to enter today's date, and you can see our cell is now highlighted. Now I'm going to show you another thing. What if you want to edit your formatting? Okay, so our formatting rules are okay, our formatting conditions are working fine, but I don't want to highlight it with yellow, I want to highlight it with red. So I don't need to create another conditional formatting. I'm going to just select the entire range and then conditional formatting, then manage rules, and here you'll find a list of conditional formatting that you have used in your worksheet. Here we have only one, so we have found that one here. And now if I click on this conditional formatting rules, which is in our M column, and if I click here edit rule, and now you can edit this formatting. Just click on the format and change the color. Okay, so this is how you can create, edit, and remove conditional formatting. Also, this is how you can highlight cell that has today's date, and you can also highlight each cell that has today's date within a column or within your selected range. This is what I wanted to show you. Thank you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next tutorial. If you can, support the channel through Patreon, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.